Bay slightly under the mainstream radar, reaches its climax today at one of the great cricket grounds. Over the last two seasons, the Royal London One Day Cup has afforded 148 to some of the brightest young talents in the domestic game their List A debut. And today offers some of those cricketers a chance to shine on the big stage and perhaps give one of the greats of the English domestic game a fitting send-off. So the sun is shining. Welcome to Trent Bridge for the final of the Royal London One Day Cup. It's Kent against Lancashire. Well, a very good morning to you. It's slightly chilly, but the sun is shining here in Nottingham. We should be in for a cracker. Lots of youngsters on show and a little bit of experience as well, talking of which is that the same Michael Atherton. A big day for some of these youngsters.
It is a big day. For those of us of a certain age, you know, we think back fondly to when it was the real showpiece occasion at the end of the season as well. It's not quite that, but as you say, I think for the players, it's still a tournament they want to win.
Well, let's find out who's doing what. Join Dominic Call.
Two captains are in the middle. Joe Denley of the Kent Spitfire, Keaton Jennings of Lancashire. Joe, you have the coin. Give it a flick. Daniels is a call by Keaton Jennings, and it's come down ahead. So it's Kent that have won the toss. Joe, what are you going to do first and why?
We're going to have a bat, Corky. You know, we've batted well throughout the competition. We've also chased well, but I feel today looks like a good wicket. So put runs on the board and put Lancashire under pressure.
Tell us about your campaign so far. What have you been impressed with as captain?
I think after the first few games, a lot of people probably would have written us off. We were down the bottom of the table, and it was almost knockout cricket for us towards the back end. And I think that's shown a lot of character, a lot of belief within the changing room, and hopefully it's kept going.
All the putting your best side. I think all this talk about the development is mental competition. That's the second element of competition. This is a silverware to win and play your best side.
And it's a brave decision because I think Kent have lost their last 8 big finals. They won the last final, I'm talking about 50-55 overs. They've lost their last 8 finals. They've not got a great record. But if they've won 5 on the bounce, I think if it had been a bit win one, lose one, and they sort of stumble their way, if they've won 5 in a row with the same captain, the same team, I reckon that's why they've stuck with this squad, because they know how to play with each other. I get that point. At the end of the day, you're only judged on your trophy. I've played in 8 finals, I've played in 5. You forget quickly the ones you lost, then you have to bowl them out for nothing, and you remember the ones you win.
Well, we'll discuss that as we go through. It's an interesting topic. Let's show you how these guys got through to the final. We have split into 2 groups. I'll show you group A to start with. Sussex Sharp and Leicester Foxes were the form horses in the group stages, but none got through. They had a home semi-final, the Sussex Sharp, but they failed. So if we flip through to group B, this is how it ended up, with Hampshire getting a home tie, Lancashire and Kent having to go through the quarter-finals. Lancashire beat Sussex and Kent beat Hampshire, who are playing some excellent cricket in Group B of the Royal London One Day Cup. But Lancashire and Kent get through the final. Let's show you what happened at Sussex when Lancashire travelled down there. They were in a right hole at one stage. They were 67-4-5, and they managed to pull it out of the bag and posted, what, 319?
Yeah, absolutely. They're in a right hole early in the beat. And they missed the start of the competition with a fractured finger, I think. George Lavelle is an exciting young wicketkeeper batsman. And they got Lancashire to over 300, which proved to be enough. But, you know, he would have had good odds on them getting here at that point at 65. A little bit like Kent, who had a really dodgy start to the competition, but then came with a real run at the end. So, in the end, both deserve to get it.
We can enjoy watching the youngsters, but in that semi-final down at home, it was an experienced hand. He'd been out, as Michael said, with a fractured finger, but Dave Villas pulled that one out. That was a fantastic one.
It was, and that's when you do need your senior players. That's where you need the experience. And he's a strong player, but you'll see him here as well. He played some delicate shots. There's a reverse sweep off the back of the bat. There it is. He's a very, very good player, very experienced cricketer. And on a day like today, you are going to need that experience, not just with the bat, but obviously Keaton Jennings. Well, I think he's quite an impressive young man, actually, Keaton Jennings. I think in a final, he's going to need Dane Vieira, the often captain's forum.
Yeah.
I think he's going to just have a quiet word with him, because he can be under pressure in a final. It's an interesting decision to toss, because generally here in white ball cricket, it is a difficult ground to protect, but maybe just in a final, get runs on the board.
One day finals are etched into the fabric of Lancashire County cricket, club, aren't they?
They are. Two particular periods that stick in the mind. Bumble's period, going way back 50 years, in the 1970s, when actually Lancashire and Kent played in a lot of showcase finals. And then obviously my era in the 90s, when we played in 8-9 finals in that decade. There is a link. Glenn Chappell, of course, is here on the coaching staff, and he was an integral part of that 90s team.
Okay, well, let's flip back to Kent, because after 26 years as a professional cricketer, 17 years with Kent, this could be the last day of Darren Stevens' professional career. He spoke earlier with Michael.
I'm delighted to say he's joined by the only man still playing that I must have played against, given that I've been retired 20 years. That ages us both, doesn't it?
It does. I was talking to somebody earlier about last time we played against each other. I think it was a semi-final at Great Strike, and I snared you a square leg, a little clip off your leg, a few years ago.
The final game then for Kent after 17 years, incredible 17 years down on the South Coast. How are your emotions ahead of this game?
Today not too bad, very relaxed, and I've had the family up, so it's been really nice for them. Little ones keeping you busy in the morning, so, you know, try not to talk about the game, but this week's been a bit tough. I've had a week off since playing the 4-day game, so it was more, you know, there was a lot of prep, but also a lot of thinking about the game and what's actually gone on over the last 17 years at Kent, and sad, but you know, I've had a good run. It's been a good time, a lot of memories, and I've enjoyed it a lot.
You've registered your disappointment because you wanted to carry on at Kent, but that's not going to happen. But you do want to keep playing, and you're talking to a couple of clubs about a player coaching role.
Yeah, I feel, at the minute, the body's good. You know, I've had a couple of niggles this year, but I've got through them. I feel like I'm hitting the ball well, and the ball's coming out nice.
has a significant amount of time, first of all. What has been, if you're looking at the county game that you played in from that point in 1997 when you made your debut to now, what has been the biggest change, do you think, in that time?
The way the game's being played now. You know, you look at the way Stokes in Baz has taken Test cricket. It's, you know, we're not looking at going up 2-3 and over anymore. It's, let's put, you know, let's get the game moving forward. Let's go 4-5 and over and put the opposition under the pump. So I just think the way the intensity's gone, the, you know, the shot that some of these lads play nowadays is ridiculous. The confidence is wide. I think, you know, that white ball cricket is showing that, you know, and they're playing, look at Ruth, he's playing reverse laps and flips over the slips in Test cricket. So that's been a good thing for me.
In some ways, you found yourself as a bit of a lightning rod for county cricket. There are county cricket has its supporters and detractors, yeah. Doesn't it? And all the supporters of county cricket, they can't see it's the best thing about the game. And then there are some detractors who say, well, that's one of the problems with county cricket, that 46-year-old is still playing. Have you felt that kind of that polarisation of opinion settling on you, and how do you cope with that?
Yeah, you know, I think the thing that gets you through it is there's a lot of people out there, there's a lot of people in my corner. So, you know, that the stuff that I want, you know, I won't listen to or read about and let it affect me, it's everybody else that comes in. And, you know, I get a lot of social media from people that are mid-40s thinking about getting something like this, but actually they keep bombing. You know, stuff like that's really nice.
Polarised opinion, and if someone is criticising the county game, isn't that
tends to be at the top of the pile. That's usually an example of what's bad about the game.
Well, it shouldn't do if it's for the reason that Ant was giving there, which is his age. We've got a 40-year-old in Test Match Cricket that seems to be doing all right, Jimmy Anderson. And we've got a 46-year-old in Kent that has been player of the season for Kent in three of their last five seasons. He has been phenomenal with bat and ball. He's also won them games from situations that Kent had no right to win. And I can tell you, batters all round county cricket will hate facing Darren Stevens for the last decade, if not longer. I think where you could argue that he polarises opinion is that the type of cricketer, you know, that we had that Australian group that came over last summer with a WhatsApp group, you know, don't let Steve-O get you or whatever they nicknamed it, because they all were worried about one cricketer. They weren't worried about Anderson and Broad and everyone in county cricket. They sort of knew how to play them. Darren Stevens, your pad looks about 15 times as long, because Steve-O will get you LBW, and he's got, you know, the likes of Labuschagne. So it's that type of cricketer who's successful in county cricket that may not be successful in international cricket, almost proving the point that there's two different forms of cricket that's been played in the last 15, 20 years. Nothing to do with Darren Stevens, not his fault.
Such a talent, though, a natural talent, and no England recognition, which always baffled me, because when I first saw him played against him, I thought, oh, this lad's got a lot.
Well, it was around in an era where, well, I almost said era, it's been around a lot of eras, but I think, you know, when perhaps he was in his 20s, 30s, there was quite a decent amount of batters around, bowlers or roundery type players as well. So he was in that era where he's one of those figures that perhaps was talked about but just didn't quite make it. You're right, he's been a very good servant of the game. And I agree with what Nasser said. Forget about age. I hate hearing age. Age is just wrong talking about cricket. If the guy is still performing, like I said, if you two batters can't hit the 46-year-old, you know, get back into the net, as we used to say, and try and learn how to play. You know, I just think, you know, what we have to do as a sport is stop blaming people and actually look at why he is a positive, experienced man in a group of young players or youngish players that can help that group of players perform.
Oh, he's not young.
I mean, he made an excellent point about being a role model for some of the older cricketers out there in club cricket. You know, today will be the last day of the season for club cricketers. And there will be 46-year-olds, but my brother still plays. He won a trophy for Essex over 50s at the weekend. If Kent over 70s just won a trophy this last weekend, there are a lot of people. No, I wasn't in that either. I'm thinking Steve-O wasn't actually, by the way, but there are a lot of people that carry on playing because they love the game. And I think Steve-O fits in that category. You have played with Stewie, I played with Graham Goose. There are certain people, it's in their blood, the game of cricket. And that'll be the hardest bit for Darren Stevens, is when he's no longer a cricketer, because that's what he's been all his life.
Well, he's been in four finals, Lord's finals, and he's lost all of them. So he's quite happy that this one is at Trent Bridge. And he, not single-handedly, but had a massive role in getting Kent to this position, because he was awesome.
Well, absolutely. This is what, you know, Steve-O can do. You know, as, you know, as Nasser said, batters don't like facing him, but also bowlers, when he's in this sort of form, they don't know where to bowl at him. Because he's a certain individual who just stands quite still, and he's very powerful. He's an excellent golf player. I think we all know that. He plays golf off a very low handicap. And you just see the way that he hits it. He's a clean hitter of a cricket ball. And when you're in a situation and you need a senior player in big match situations to get you over the line, he's the man to actually do it, and has done it throughout his career.
Well, VS did it for Lancashire in their semi, and Stevens did it for Kent in their semi final. What's all about a lot of youngsters that we'll be talking about throughout the day? There are only two Ollie Robinson. We're going to talk about the Kent Ollie Robinson.
He's 206 against Worcester, and his form just continues.
He has. He's been quite brilliant. He's moved up the order. That's the one advantage that if you had Crawley, Val Drummond, if you had Billings, he'd be coming in at 6 or 7. But right at the start, he was moved up to number 3. He got a double 100 at Worcester. He got runs in the semi-final. He's had runs right. He's their leading run getter. And I can tell you what as well.
All right, for God's sake, man.
He speaks to quite a few umpires on the circuit. And you ask him to name some of the best clubmen on the circuit. Ollie Robinson, the wicketkeeper, is exceptional as well. So that's where this tournament has been good. Because of the 100, you have to play players, not only playing, he'd have played anyway, but given much more of a role, and he has responded to that role at the top of the order.
Bless us and wicketkeeper batsman, that's for sure.
Quickly, the right decision to bat first, given out of the toss, now says difficult to defend.
Yes, because of this arena, definitely have a bat first, get the runs on the board for the opposition under pressure. I think it's the right decision. So, well, Kent will be back in first here in the final of the Royal London One Day Cup, and we've got the anthem when we come back.
easyJet holidays helping.
Matthew with his first goal is joining Mike from Strasbourg this summer. 1-1. Mike stays fixed. Hertha 1 point clear of the relegation playoff place. Not long to go now until Canelo Alvarez and Gennady Golovkin meet for the third time in a blockbuster fight. There you go, head-to-head tonight for the undisputed super middleweight world title. Both fighters took to the stage in front of a packed crowd in Las Vegas. They are meeting a super middleweight this time. Golovkin, who is moving up in weight. And it was he who weighed in the heavier of the two.
What? It's a huge honour to be here. I'm so excited, so happy. I'm going to give everything I can every single day.
Fresh start for Chelsea and an exciting move for one of the league's brightest head coaches. Just 48 hours after parting ways with Thomas Tuchel, Graham Potter was installed in the Canterbury top seat last week. The 47-year-old knows he won't be able to survive on reputation alone, but with a proven track record of creating an environment where players can thrive, Potter goes in.
And insights to help you pick the best investments and avoid the worst. You work hard for your money, best invested. Open an account and start investing today.
Thank you. Please remain upstanding for the national anthem, Tom Swain Ricketts. Thank you.
good morning and welcome along to Tredbridge in Nottingham, the final of this one-day 50-over competition, Royal London Cup final between Kent and Lancashire. Minute silence for the third edition of God Save the King has set us on our way. Umpires just taking the middle, Paul Pollard and Russell Warren. Both teams standing respectfully during the minute silence, along with a good crowd here at Trent Bridge. And God Save the King echoing around this grand old cricket ground. So the news from the toss is that Kent have won the toss on a glorious morning. Here's hardly a cloud in the sky. It's good sunshine, a bit chilly. Lancashire probably wanted to do the same, but it looks a really good pitch here. Kent unchanged from their semi-final. They could have picked any number of the players who could take from the 100, but policy those players who got to the final. Similarly with Lancashire, who make just one change, Rob Jones coming into the team, George Balls. Alex Tudor's alongside me. Morning to you, Tudor.
Yeah, good morning, Paul. Good morning, everybody. What it's about. Domestic players playing in the final, Royal London final here at Trent Bridge. An opportunity for a lot of lads to be household names, show everyone what they can do. Obviously, we've got Darren Stevens playing for Kent, 46 years old, what a career.
Well, Tom Bailey will have the bowling for Lancashire from the pavilion in here. Tom Bailey is not vastly experienced in domestic one-day cricket. He's trained as a high-quality spec ball bowler. He's got little experience over the last couple of years. Ben Compton preparing to take strike, and he's been Kent's most consistent batter through this tournament. Very consistent run scorer. Averaging 42 in this tournament this season. So we're underway then. Tom Bailey to Ben Compton. Easy pace, first delivery. No great signs of any horrors there. Not much swing and just gentle pace through the keeper.
Yeah, just probably would have been extremely nervous, but getting that first one out of the way, if they just sort of just back of the length, didn't fly through the batsman, then Compton just had no much look at it.
Pushed into the offside by Compton. He'll come and have a look at where that pitched. I think it just came off perhaps a little bit slower than he thought. 550s to his name in this competition in 9 matches so far. Two slips waiting, just a pretty conventional field. We have 3 on the offside and 3 on the leg side, 2 on the leg side, sorry. We don't mean wicket. And third man. Circle.
Yeah, decent start. Decent line, decent length.
And gone. What a start. What a start for Tom Bailey. Compton goes for naught. Kent have lost their first wicket.
Oh my word! Kent has won by 1 wicket!
Yeah, just Ben Compton has to depart for naught.
choice. With thousands of really neat cars and vans at unbeatable prices, all under warranty. We'll buy your car too. It's so quick and easy. And we'll help you buy the car you want your way. From visiting your local Motorpoint store with same day drive away, to reserve and collect online with free home delivery. Motorpoint. Nobody beats us on price.
Ollie Robinson is the new batsman for Kent. Coming in, he plays Tom Bailey, who's got a wicket in the fourth ball of the match. Robinson, who set Kent's tournament alone, a very first game, a double hundred, 260 against Worcester. Standout score of the tournament.
Yes!
For him, but for Kent as well. Made 95 in the semi-final, and is one of Kent's key backers. Be wide down the leg side. Just a bit of a four ball from Tom Bailey to get the wicket of Compton, pushing it back way outside off stump. Stephen Croft taking the catch at backward point. Stroke gully. Taken the new ball with one of these two. time was in these late season finals when the side winning the toss would invariably bowl first. Not today.
Bit of anomaly, like 10:30 starts as well, weren't they?
Well, out of his crease now, Emerson turning guard. Tommy Robinson, Emerson yet to face the ball, it's been nearly two overs.
Setting himself in. Just going back to that one with Tommy Robinson batting out of his crease. I'm sure Stephen Crawford would have laid that back to mid-off, let the bowler know. It's just a chance out of his crease, he's just dragged his legs back. Really good shot.
There's been a piece of aggression of the morning, timed beautifully. 8-4.
That's a beautiful executed drive, just a tad full. Just going through with it. Through the long off. Fantastic cricket shot, presenting the full face of the blade. It's a great sight for any batsman. Getting the opening bowler down the ground. Good shot. Good start.
So, Joey Edison finally gets on strike on loan to Kent, but he's signed for them for next year and has grown up here at Trent Bridge. Came through the Nottingham Academy. Played here earlier in his career. He's gone past the outside edge without a great degree of movement. Just playing and missing on the back foot there, Edison.
This is what he does day in, day out. A little bit of nibble. Starting back. Too good for the batter.
Well, first impressions are this is a pretty easy pace pitch. Not really seen much seam movement. That would be why in years gone by, captains would want to bowl first. Early start in September, there's an awful lot of dew on the ground this morning when we got here. Maybe a bit of dampness in the surface helping the new ball bowlers. Doesn't appear to be much of that at the moment.
Yeah, when those early starts, captains were always a little bit pensive. They're always looking to bowl first. Nasser alluded to earlier on when Glenn Chappell had a fantastic final bowling Essex out, and it was doing all sorts.
Just nicked back a touch, running the ball back into the right hander, which is what Bailey does so effectively.
Talk about this scramble scene, don't they, as it goes down, first a bit of wobble, and then when it hits the seam, it just nips one way or another, just nipping it back. Good bowling.
Edison off the mark, he'll look to soon get them. A gentle push into the leg side.
That will settle his nerves off the mark in the final. Good shot. Into the gap. Good wicket. Area for two. Good.
Solidly forward. Three overs gone. 10-1. Good start this from Asia. Accurate bowling. Just the one boundary. 10 overs of power play when two fielders only allowed out of the circle. those fielding restrictions gradually relaxed through the game. Williams straight driven for four by Robinson off the last ball of his previous over. And that's meant that one of the slips comes out to short fine leg, deep backward square now. And his wicket mid on three on the offside, saving one. .285 is the average score batting first here in 50 over cricket. Scoring ground and high scoring ground as well. Perhaps best illustrated, I think, by the T20 average, which is 192.
Yeah, not many bowlers like turning up here in T20 cricket.
Just a slight pause whilst umpire Paul Pollard tells batsman and fielding captain, there's no DRS from just this end, the Radcliffe Road end. That's at the moment, I think. We need to correct that pretty quickly. Good shot again on the up through the offside. Won't go for four. Kept down to two.
Very organised, Bobby Robinson. Just leaning into that shot. Really good execution, just getting himself forward. Evading cover there. Two more runs. Great shot, good balance.
Each team will have two unsuccessful reviews per innings. Another change in the field now. Reinforcing the offside, extra cover going in, so they've got a backward point or deep gully. Cover, extra cover mid off. Three on the leg side. Short fine leg, deep backward square, and a straightish mid on, the big gap through mid wicket. The cover's doing his job. It's closing that gap between extra cover and cover. Rob Jones back in the side today. The only change from Lancashire's semi-final lineup, replacing George Balderson, who will feel a touch unlucky. Got 100 against Kent in the group game. George Balderson, 106 not out. Unfortunately, 12th man today. Extra cover.
Yeah, good line, good length. Keep Craven outside there. That's what Captain Jennings with one. Decent start, 12 for one. After the full cover.
And it's pushed up the back foot. And then the fielder. Good piece of fielding. It's 14-4.
Saturday night football. at Leicester Club in Scotland, live from Strand Wall.
10:14 for one from four overs, steady start. Given that they lost Compton in the first over. Bailey to continue, just a slip. Just to confirm, we've got full DRS from the Pavilion end, but not from the Radcliffe Road end at the moment. Get the feeling, Alex, that these passmen are just waiting to tee off. Just gentle pace and not seeing much swing or any movement really off the scene.
Yeah, I have to agree with you, Paul. I was feeling the same thing, like something violent is going to happen very soon.
The calm before the storm, this, I think.
Possibly has a long on. I've got a feeling sort of long on with wicket. That vacant area there, I've got a feeling something violent may happen in that area. As you said, it's not much going on as in regards of movement. His length's been good. Good figures for Bailey. Three overs, no mains, one for five. And a distinct lack of width or anything short from Lancashire's bowlers. Yeah, they've been outstanding. It's exactly what Keegan Jennings, the captain, would want. They lose in the toss on the ball first. I think he said at the toss to Dominic Corbett. Would also have liked it first, but this is a fantastic start. Getting that early wicket of Compton, who's been in fantastic form. As you said, Paul, they've not erred on width at all for these batters.
Not so far.
Williams again.
That's found the gap between mid-on and mid-wicket, who's in, and that's away before. Edison gets his first boundary of the morning.
This is a fantastic cricket shot. Not width on order, but just a little bit too full in the execution of that shot. It's fantastic. Look at the balance, head position, mid wicket, no chance.
Trent, the length back a fraction. Just a bit too full, that first delivery. Edison putting it away. Joey Edison, the youngest player in the match today, at 20 years of age.
just playing outside of his eye line. Good team presentation, just nibbling away. Good delivery. Not much carry though. Keeper taking it down by his shins. But that'll be encouraging.
Lancashire have gone in with just five frontline bowlers. Balderson, the all-rounder, being left out for Rob Jones. Williams, Bailey, Hurt, Milan, the four seamers or quicker bowlers. Wells will bowl his spin. Stephen Croft can bowl. DRS back in action at both ends. So, okay, to go for those reviews now. Should they be needed?
Yeah, sort of, you get caught up with all the T20 and 100. This is sort of going back old school a little bit. The batters taking their time. Seeing off the new ball.
Yeah, getting or chasing 300 has become, I won't say the norm, but it's become less daunting. It's almost, certainly in Lancashire's case, when they played a couple of games at Blackpool, small ground, good pitch, 300 is 300 plus has been a stock score.
Bowling again from Tom Bailey. And all his experience, this is what he does. But just the height.
Yeah, it's Bailey's stop delivery that just nips back into the right hand. And he knew it was too high.
Something was coming in, that sort of pick up. Didn't quite get to the man, he's a deep square. Liam Hurt out there, steaming in, making that decision to get it on the one bounce. Robinson's heart would have been in his mouth for a little bit. He's still there.
final ball of the seventh over. It's 22 for 1. Beautiful day now, bright blue sky, very, very chilly this morning when the players arrived at the ground, but it looks like we're set for a lovely afternoon. Beautiful ground, not full by any stretch, Trent Bridge, but not a bad turnout. Should just get it over King Jennings at mid-off, who was hanging on the edge of the circle. I think he sensed that this is the time that Dane Villas, correction, senses that this is the time that Ollie Robinson wants to get cracking.
Just a little bit over-pitched, wasn't it? There, really, to go a little bit straight and slice it and get that over Dane Villas.
Those earlier shots down the ground, this was played with beautiful touch.
Yeah, Williams just brings his length back. It's good from Robinson because he gets on top of the bounce. So it goes square, and once you get it past the infield here at Trent Bridge, such a quick outfield, they all race away. Joe Denley, who won the toss a little bit earlier and decided to have a bat first. Lost that first wicket of Ben Compton early on. A little bit of a repair job done so far. Looks a decent pitch, maybe slightly slower, since we're in September and it's always going to be perhaps a little bit tackier.
Bowls a very straight line, very accurate bowler.
too much. But that's the one good thing about this competition. We talked about it at the top of the show and asked the captains about, you know, playing younger players that are coming through, and this is what's good about this competition. Just a 20-year-old who is in a final. He's a good player.
What happens as well, and maybe this is the case with Joey Everson, this is a tournament that allows young players an opportunity. Then they get a sniff of playing in the first team. And then are impatient for their career to develop.